This is video number 23 from digital-university.org. In this video, we're going to look at a circuit that has different types of sources. It has a current source and a voltage source. And what we're going to do is find the equivalent circuit for this simply by doing different manipulations on the current and the voltage source. First thing we notice is that here we have a resistor that's in parallel with the current source. So if we want to, we could redraw this part of the circuit where this resistor would be in series with a voltage source where the magnitude of the voltage source is equal to the product of this resistance and that amount of current. And this is what we developed in the last video, where this current of this circuit and this circuit are equivalent, provided that the voltage source here, the magnitude of that, is equal to the product of the resistor that's in parallel with current source. So multiply this times this, that's 64 over 3 volts. And then now the resistor, 2 ohm resistor, would be in series like this. So now we've redrawn the circuit. This has a value of 64 thirds ohms with this polarity. So put out a current in this direction, which is the same direction that our current source was. So here's the 2 ohm resistor, the 4 ohm resistor, the 6 ohm resistor, 3 ohm resistor, and our 8 volt voltage source here. Now, if we convert this end of the circuit to a current source, that would put this resistor in parallel with the current source, and in parallel with this resistor, so we could determine their equivalent resistance. And of course, the way we do that is, just what we did in the previous video, again, these two circuits are equivalent provided that the current here is equal to this voltage divided by that resistance. So here we would have this voltage divided by that resistance. That would be a current source of 8 thirds amps. In this direction. And now this resistor is in parallel to the current source. Like this. Because, again, as we did in the previous video, this resistor that's in series with the voltage source is now in parallel with the current source. These are equivalent, provided that the magnitude of the current is equal to that voltage divided by that resistance. And now these are in parallel, so these two parallel resistors, the equivalent resistance is the product divided by the sum, so it's 18 divided by 9, which is 2. So we can replace these just with a 2 ohm resistor, a single 2 ohm resistor. So now we have this. And now, You can go back if you want to and put this as a voltage source. This would be in series with the voltage source if you put this resistor in series with these other resistors. So we can do that provided that the magnitude of the voltage source is the product of this resistor and that current source. So let's make some room and do that. This is 2 ohms, this is 4 ohms. This now goes up to be in series with the voltage source, where the magnitude of the voltage source is the product of this and this, so this is 16 thirds. And this is 64 thirds. And here we have a series resistance of 8 ohms. Now here, this battery is putting out this voltage source. We're putting the current out in this direction, and so with this one. So here they're opposing each other. So here then the net voltage source would be this minus this. So we have 64 minus 16. Divided by 3, and that's 48 divided by 3, so that's 16 volts, and this is 8 ohms, so finally, here comes our equivalent circuit. And that's it. So, to get from here, our original circuit, all the way down to here, we didn't have to use any current mesh analysis or any node analysis techniques. It was just simply manipulating the circuit by using our source conversion techniques that we discussed in the previous video. Now, it's seldom that you're going to find a circuit and you can analyze the whole circuit just by doing manipulations on the different sources that you have available. But many times, it might be advantageous if you have a current source and a resistor in parallel with it. It might be advantageous to convert that to a voltage source with the resistor in series with that in order to be able to make the circuit more amenable to a mesh current analysis technique. Or perhaps, as we will see, it might be in certain situations more advantageous if you have a voltage source and a resistor in series with it. It might be more advantageous to convert that to a current source with that resistor in parallel with it, and that might make it more amenable to a node analysis technique. So there's different manipulations that we can do with the different sources in the circuit that might make it amenable to one technique or another in order to make it easier to analyze the circuit. Anyway, that's all we had to say about this video. We just want to kind of get a demonstration as to how you can do source conversions that can sometimes make your circuits easier to analyze. Okay, I'll come back, join us in the next video, and then we're going to start solving problems using the node analysis technique.